Yo, what's up, guys? How are you? Fine. Welcome to this tutorial. Today we're gonna look at what's the difference between Habasha and Ethiopian, and also what's the difference between Habasha and Eritrean. You know, guys, a lot of time people are mixing or people are confused, they can't differentiate the difference between being an Ethiopian and being a Habasha, and also people can't differentiate being an Eritrean citizen and being an Habasha. So today in this video, I'm gonna illustrate what is the reality and what is the difference between Habasha and Eritrea or Ethiopia. So let's get started. First of all, what is the meaning of Habasha? This Habasha word, where is originally it comes from? Where is the origin? Which countries? Where it's originated? Habasha word. Which language is Habasha word? And which ethnic group represent Habasha? Ethiopia is made up of around 85 ethnic groups. Also Eritrea is made up of 9 ethnic groups. So which ethnic groups represent Habasha? A lot of time on YouTube or on social media, you hear a lot of people claiming they are Habasha and they are from Horn Africa, whether they claim Ethiopian or Eritrean. But that is not true. Those people not represent Ethiopia or Eritrean. Those people who claim Habasha are minority in both countries. They are minority in Ethiopia and in Eritrea, but in social media they are majority. they control the social media. On YouTube you see a lot of girls, I am Habasha, and a lot of foreigners think all Ethiopians and Eritreans are Habasha and they are the majority, but that's not true and that's a lie. So in this video, I'm gonna we're gonna look at who are Habasha and who are not Habasha, and what's the meaning of Habasha, and where it's originated from, and are they majority or minority in both country, and where they these people, where they located, their area or their region. We will look all of this information in this video. So guys, I hope you're enjoying this video. So let's get started. First of all, the word Habasha is not an Amharic language and a Tigrayan language. Habasha, those who claim Habasha are, there are two ethnic groups who claim they are Habasha. They are Tigray ethnic groups and Amhara ethnic groups. Those two ethnic groups, they claim they are Habasha. But the rest of Ethiopian and Eritrean, like Oromo, Somali, Saho, Afar, And all, you know, 84 ethnic groups, they don't call themselves Habasha. Only Amhara and the Tigray are, those who call themselves, Habasha. So, what is the meaning of Habasha? Is Habasha word derived from Amharic or Tigregna? No, Habasha word is derived from Arabic language. Habasha means in Arabic, translation. Al-Habasha means Ethiopia in Arabic. Habashi means citizens of Ethiopia. Arab, call all people from Horn Africa, whether you are Ethiopian or Eritrean or Somali. In ancient time, they call, people from, Horn Africa, they call Habash. Habash means, burned face. It means, it translated, Ethiopia means a burned face. Habasha means by Arabic, it's a burned face. People not dark, not black, not white, brown people, Habasha. Arabic people use this word to identify the people from Horn Africa. They don't use for only Amhara people or Tigrinya people. But Arabic, Saudi Arabian or, Middle Eastern people use Habasha term for people from Horn Africa. But the people from Horn Africa don't call themselves Habasha. Only Tigray and Amhara call themselves Habasha. And the first person who called Habashi is a Muslim person. He is a companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Islamic. His name is Bilal. Arab call him Bilal Habashi. Al-Habasha means Ethiopia in Arabic. Habashi means citizen of Ethiopia, one of the companion of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Name was Bilal Habashi, and in the history of Islam, the first Muslim was Bilal Habashi, who gave the prior call. He is the first one who, who be told he is Habasha. Before Bilal, there is no person who called himself Habasha. So, who is Bilal? And which ethnic group represented Bilal? Is Bilal from Amhara, Tigregna, Oromo, Somali? No one know. But he is just from Horn Africa. So, I wanted to say, Arabic people use Habasha word for all people from Ethiopia, Eritrea, and Somalia, not for those two ethnic groups today who claim themselves they are Habasha, But today in modern, 2020 or in 21st century, only two ethnic groups, majority of them, and there are also minority groups like Gurage, and Silte, like that, they call themselves Habasha too. But they don't have even, specific region, they live, in separately, in Ethiopia. They have no specific region. So, majority of, people who call themselves Habasha is Amhara and Tigrinya. Tigray people live, they are resident in Eritrea and Ethiopia. But Amhara is only, bordered in Ethiopia. They live only in Ethiopia, that is Habasha. So now we're going to look at are Habasha represent Ethiopia? Are all Ethiopian are Habasha? How, what is the percentage of Habasha people in Horn Africa? We will look at Now, first of all, in Eritrea, we have this map. Eritrea has 9 ethnic groups. The majority of ethnic groups called Tigre. This is a green one, you know, a green map. The second majority is Afar. This orange, you know, map. Afar. They are 9. So in Eritrea, how percentages, you know, Habasha? Only one ethnic group is Habasha in Eritrea. The rest are not Habasha. All are Kushitic. The rest of Eritrea are Kushitic. Only Tigregna, this brown, you know, you see here brown, you know, this gray, you know, like a gray color here, Tigregna. These people represent Habasha in Eritrea. The rest are Muslim and Kushitic. You know, most of Kushitic people are Muslim, you know, and a lot of Habasha people are Christians. 90% of Habashan are Christians. By the way, guys, Habasha means Abyssinians. You know, the Abyssinian history in Horn Africa, they have, you know, a huge history in Horn Africa. They are, you know, connected with Christianity. They got, you know, military power and a gun and a lot of things from, you know, European, as you know, previous time. They were fighting, you know, Kushitic people in Horn Africa. They enslaved Kushitic people. They ruled this area, you know, for a long time, you know. And Habasha Kushitic people are, you know, fighting, you know, with the Habasha people for a long time. So here in Eritrea, we have only one ethnic group who represent Habasha. They are Tigregna. This is a gray color map. The rest of Eritrean population are Kushite. So now what you understand in this video, Eritrea is not a Habasha land. Only in YouTube, you know, in YouTube you see a lot of Tigregna people saying, I am Habasha from Eritrea, like that. But the reality, they are a minority, you know, in Eritrea. Even though, you know, the current leader, Isaias Afwerki, a dictator, is from this ethnic group, the Habasha ethnic group, the Tigregna, he didn't, you know, allow any, you know, is from ethnic groups from Tigregna. He didn't allow any election, because if he make you know, a democratic election, he know he will lose for Kushitic people. So he just, you know, using his military power and oppressing, you know, the majority of Kushitic people in Eritrea. So now you understand, you know, how, you know, minority they are, Habasha people in Eritrea, and they don't represent Eritrea, because Tigre, Saho, Rashida, Nara, Kunama, Hedera, Bilen, Afar are Kushite people, and they are Muslims. So let's get jump to Ethiopia. You know, here in the top one, the map is Eritrea map is on the top, and this map is Ethiopian map. Abyssinians are this, you know, you see this map on you know, red color. Abyssinian region or land is only this in Horn Africa. In Ethiopia, you see 70% of Ethiopia population are not Habasha. In Eritrea, 70% of Eritrean population are not Habasha. They are minority in both countries, you know. They don't represent. When you come out the Somali, you know, Somali are, the biggest, they own, you know, the biggest land or, you know, territorial. Somali own, you know, the biggest territory in Horn Africa. They all are, you know, kushite. When you come to Sudan, Nubians are kushite. So in Horn Africa or in Ethiopia and Eritrea, Habesha people are minority in both country. You know, Ethiopia is made up of, you know, nine regional states. Every ethnic groups have their own region. Some ethnic groups are gathered together in one state, like, you know, southern nation and nationality. There are more than, you know, 60 ethnic groups who live in this region. But when you come to Oromia, the biggest ethnic groups in Ethiopia, you know, they are kushite. And when you come to the second, you know, largest region, state region in Ethiopia, is the Somali. They are kushite. The third biggest ethnic state in Ethiopia is Afar. They are kushite. Look, this green, blue, and here, you know, like a purple, they are kushite. When you come to the Benushangul and the Gambela, they are, you know, nilotic. And even southern nation and nationality are kushite, because we have, you know, a lot of ethnic groups in this area. They are a mix of nilotic and kushite in this. No single Semitic is here. So we have here Amhara region, who call themselves Habasha or Abyssinians, and the Tigre region. And in Amhara region, we have a lot of other kushite ethnic groups who live inside, you know, Amharic region. We have in Amhara region, you know, others ethnic groups who live in Amhara region, like Agaw, Oromo, Agaw, Awi or Kimant, or Goba, Wollo, etc. When you come to the Wollo are, you know, majority of them are, you know, Muslim. And in Amhara region, they have huge region within Amhara region. This red color map you see is a Wollo territory in Amhara region. So Amhara people have no specific, you know, his own region, because other kushite ethnic groups live inside Amhara region. Non-Habasha ethnic groups. And when you come to Tigray region, this the Tigray region, when you come to Tigray region, here the green one, there are also a lot of ethnic groups in Tigray region. Ethnic groups in Tigray. Not all region of Tigray are, you know, Habasha or Abyssinians. There are a lot of kushite ethnic groups who live there. We have, you know, like Saho, Kunama, Tamanya, and you know, we have a lot of, you know, ethnic groups who live inside, you know, Tigray region. So now what you understand is Abyssinians or Habasha people are very minority in, you know, in Horn Africa. When you see at this map, Abyssinians are this, you know, they are very minority. The purple color are all are Kushitic. Djibouti, 70% of Eritrea, 75% of or 70% of Ethiopian are Kushitic, and you know, 5% is Nilotic, you know, 50% are Semitic. When you come to the Somali and even in Kenya, you see how Kushitic people are, you know, controlled, you know, the whole Horn Africa. But when it comes to politics, the Semitic people are controlled politically, because in Ethiopia they control, you know, the capital city of Ethiopia. Almost 70% of the, you know, people who resident in Addis Ababa are Habasha people, whether they are Amhara or Tigray. They control economy and politics in, you know, Horn Africa, because, you know, Kushitic people are almost, you know, Muslim. And, you know, at this time, when you are a Muslim, you know, you don't have any help from, you know, the warlord. The warlord, you know, American, European, look at you, you know, in, you know, different. They hate you. They don't want, you know, some person from, you know, Kushitic person who to be a president or, you know, to rule this territory. That's why, you know, this small minority of Habasha people are in Eritrea and Ethiopia controlled all the Horn Africa. Now in Eritrea, Habasha are ruling, even though in Ethiopia now Abiy Ahmed is represent Oromo ethnic groups, but he do proud of himself. I don't know what. Every time, you know, he make himself like, you know, Amhara people, you know, politically, you know, he is, you know, I don't know what, you know, I call him. So that is the reality, you know, difference between being a Habasha or, you know, Ethiopian or Eritrean, you know, those people are minority in both country. Only two ethnic group call themselves Habasha, Tigray or Amhara, but the rest of Eritrea and Ethiopian are Kushitic people, my 80% almost. But, you know, politically, they, and you know, YouTube, on YouTube, they are majority, you know, you see a lot of, oh, I'm Habasha, like that, you know, only on YouTube, but the reality is not like that. The Kushitic people are the majority of Horn Africa. Everybody knows that. So, what's the difference between, you know, Kushite and Habasha people? You know, when it comes, you know, but you know, the feature of their face, their hair, or you know, genetically they have no difference. Now, you know, these people, this photo is from Amhara people. As you see, you know, both Kushite people and you know, Habasha people have a dark skin people and a light skin people. All of them are mixed. You can't differentiate between, you know, even though, you know, they have a little bit difference, you know, but a foreigner can't differentiate where this person is from, you know, is Habasha or Oromo or Somali or Kushite. Foreigners can't differentiate. But we, when you're born, you know, in Eritrea or Ethiopia or, you know, in Somalia, you know, this person is a Somali or Oromo or Tigray or Amhara, you know. But there is no, you know, for example, now, you know, when you you look at, you know, a German person and someone from Poland or from Russia or Russia, they are not the same, you know, there is, you know, a little bit difference between them. But the foreigners can't differentiate a person from Germany and, you know, a person from England, British. But a German person or a European person can differentiate, and he know where this person is from, German or, you know, but a foreigner can't differentiate like that. We know, you know, there's a little bit, you know, difference, you know, the, you know, the difference between, you know, them, but a lot of them are the same. Habashans are not beautiful than Kushite or Oromo. Tigray are not beautiful than Amhara. Amhara are not beautiful than Oromo. They are beautiful person in, you know, within in every, you know, ethnic groups. They are ugly, you know, person in all those ethnic groups, you know. Ugly person or beautiful person not represent, you know, or only for one ethnic groups, you know. They are mixed, you know. Now, you know, these people are, you know, Amhara people. Look, you will find some people, you know, light skin people, and the dark skin people also too. Oral, you know. Now this photo is, you know, mostly Amhara people are like that. When you go to the Amhara region, like Gojam and Gondar, Gojam and Gondar, the Amhara people have this feature, you know. Their head, the head bone of their head is very big. Amhara, you know, Amhara people have, you know, a big head, you know, this, you know, a kaka, you know. The bone of the head is very big, and you know, they don't have bald. They have hair, you know, full hair, you know. But when it comes to Somali person, where is the Somali people? Look, most Somali person have bald, even though, you know, they have, you know, now this is, you know, the Somali president, look. This is a previous Somali president. Most Somali people have bald. You know, look, look, this is a Somali people. But their skin color is not different. You will get some, you know, light skin person in Somali, in Somali, and you will get some light skin person in Amhara or Tigray, and also you will find some dark skin person in Somali or Amhara or, you know, Oromo. For example, now, you know, Mustafa Omar, president of current Ethiopian Somali region president. You will find, you know, Somali person, almost Somali person are like this, you know, this man. This guy is, you know, a Somali regional state. Look, they have bald. Most Somali have bald, while Amhara person, most of them have no bald. But their skin color is, you know, not different. When you come to Oromo people, Look, when we see now Abiy Ahmed or Jawar Muhammad, they have type of this, skin color, the features of, like this. This is a light skin people. We have also, in all ethnic, whether they are Habasha or, kushite, dark skin people. For example, Eritrean president is Afar. Eritrean president is a Habasha, Tigray ethnic groups. When you look, he looks like this, even though, this man is a little bit light skin. Now, this is a Tigray. Yes. Okay, this is a Jawhar. Look, this Oromo, Kushite. We have here Tigray, is Habasha. We have here, where is Mustafa Omar, the Somali region. Where Mustafa Omar, yeah. We have here also Somali Kushite, Eritrean Habasha, and Jawar Muhammad Kushite. Look, there is no difference between them. But most some people think that Habashans are beautiful than Kushite people. No, there is no difference. The difference between these groups only the idea. Politically, they don't understand each other with politics. Those Habasha people, they want to control, everything. Now, in both countries, in Ethiopia and Eritrea, the official language is the Habasha language. In Ethiopia, amhara is the official language. In Eritrea, tigregna is the official language. While they are a minority in both country, you see, the Habasha people they don't like democracy. They don't believe in equality. They always, think they are, super race than, other ethnic groups. They hate other, black people from other African countries like Kenya or Sudan or another West Africans. They hate, that's the difference. Why, when you come to Kushite people, they love other African people. They believe they are a black person and African, but the Habasha people don't believe they are, they are Africans. Another difference between those ethnic groups is culture. Most Habasha people have no culture, specific culture. They think religion is, represent a culture.